Well, that was a very chill start to our afternoon here at Disney Resorts on a Sunday. Sundays? Okay, in our last video, we just talked about how Mondays are the new Fridays. I think Sundays are the new Tuesdays. This is just positively delightful so far. Very relaxed, very calm, very relaxing.
Hey, David.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Just like Nepal. Nice, quiet Nepal. I'm hoping the rest of Disneyland is much like Nepal. We're getting here at noon, so it's not exactly the best time, but we do have a couple Main Street vehicles coming out. Where's he at? There's Matt right there. There's Matt. But I think today we'll walk it up Main Street. It's a little less quiet Nepal-like right now, but you'll notice again, I'm having such a hard time with my gimbal. We're going handheld again today. My gimbal, for whatever reason, it cannot handle an Ultra, a Galaxy Ultra 21 I have. It cannot stay balanced. I took some footage earlier that you just saw, and that was so lopsided. The whole thing is like this, right? I'm filming like this the whole time and I can't get it to go like this. No matter how I try to balance it, it doesn't work because it's not calibrated. It's just a magnet and it does all the calibration. But you know what? If there's anybody out there who can recommend a gimbal that can handle a big fat phone, like a Samsung Galaxy Ultra 21 or 22 or whatever, that I use the DJI OM4 now. Here comes the streetcar. And it is known to not be very compatible with Androids to begin with. Nor is the 5. The 6 is coming out, but that thing telescopes. The OM6 telescopes like a selfie stick, so I can't bring that in the park either.
Got one black.
Even if I wanted to. So this day, by the way, is going to be, I don't know. I don't know. I haven't been to the park. I got up, or what was it, last night? Because, you know, Sophia's been sick. And so I canceled a bunch of reservations that I had. I haven't been in the park since, it's got to be almost a week now again. It's Monday. It was Monday. It was the day that Liz and I, on our Grand California Day. That was the last time I was here. And it's been pretty busy. It's been pretty busy the last couple visits we had that night and the next day. So I'm kind of pleased to see that it's not so busy. Sunday's really relaxing. I missed the park and I haven't been down here for a little bit. A little bit for me is 6 days, apparently. And there's nothing new happening. I've got nothing to show you. So we're going to do what Disney does really well. And that's just show us a good time around the park, hopefully. Before we do anything, but I'd stop over here at the Hub, pay my respects to Walt and Mickey for creating this place that we love so much, where I could just casually show up and enjoy myself. Very, very grateful to what they've created here. Let's go find some of that. You know, I walked through the tunnel entrance on the left today, and I made sure to pay special attention to the posters, to acknowledge those posters and to enjoy them and appreciate them, which I love attraction posters. I've got a half a dozen of them around the house somewhere or all over the place. So I love those. I think that we're going to have to do some of this. You know what? One thing I've got to do, I think, is have some. There's a Tropical Hideaway poster in there. I need to get into some Tropical Hideaway. It's been a minute. They've got the Lumpia and what else? I don't know. Oh, ooh, a Bao. We can get a Bao and a Lumpia and maybe a Dole Whip also. But it's a little early in the show for that, so we're going to hold off. Matter of fact, it might be a good idea anyway because it's peak lunchtime right now. So I'm going to hold off for a minute and find something else to do here in Adventureland. Is there anything fun to do here in Adventureland? Actually, let's take a peek at that queue before we go anywhere, which is, I've seen worse. That's a 30 or 40 minute queue at least. But the good news is there's no mobile order at Tropical Hideaway, so you don't have to compete with that. So it's just those people that are in that queue that you're competing with. Oh my gosh, but what about Bengal Barbecue, you guys? How am I supposed to be hungry and walk through Adventureland and not consider Bengal Barbecue? Jungle Cruise looks delightful. There's nobody upstairs. That's a 30-minute wait. Nothing happening up there. Nothing happening down here. I don't even know what time it is that we're getting into this queue. When we stop, I'll check the time. Okay, we are going upstairs. Okay, we got in at 12:35. I mean, if it's a half an hour, I'll be shocked, because this is the extent of the whole queue right here. That's everything. And there's no lightning lane on this either, so this is all we have to deal with. I'm guessing 15, 12:35.
Jungle Cruise, my name is Bella, and I'll be your skipper for as far as we get. Now before we get too far, I do need to remind you all, for a safe journey, please supervise your children and remain seated at those hands, arms, feet, legs, inside of the boat. Alright, all that lame stuff out of the way. Everybody, raise your right hand, reach under your seat, and then please try to find your sense of humor, because I think we might need it. Alright, now looks like we begin our journey right here in the rainforest. Frickin' rains up to 385 days a year. Could you imagine that? Like almost every single day. Now up ahead on the right, check it out. That's the Temple of the Forbidden Isle. The inside is where famous archaeologist Dr. Indiana Jones is looking for the world's greatest treasure. And little does he know that I'm standing right here. And over there on your left is our first resident of the Jungle Cruise. Everybody, check it out. Up on those steps is a 500-pound Indo-Chinese tiger. Okay, now a little pop quiz. Can anybody tell me why tigers have stripes? Why? Yeah. Are you going to say the same thing? Yeah? I was going to say to avoid being spotted. Alright, moving on. Now we're entering into the sacred Indian elephant bathing pool. And look at that, everyone. The whole herd is out. Now that really is unheard of. Oh, I think one of them's trying to get our attention up ahead. Okay, everybody, go ahead and wave hi to Bertha. Everybody say hi, Bertha. Oh, look at her go. Yeah, we hear you. I think she likes that. And hey, there's actually one more who wants to say hi. I almost forgot. Everybody get ready to give a great big warm welcome to Squirt. Say hi. No, Squirt, that's not how we say hi. Okay, let's try that one more time. Oh no. Okay, actually everybody, I think it might be coming back up. I'm just kidding, it's okay. Just a little bit of dry humor, there's no need to panic. But I do want to show you my camp up ahead. It's been a whole lot of... You know what, never mind, let's just stay in this boat. Wow, this whole group of monkeys has taken over. Okay, it'll be fine. Just as long as you don't make any sounds like a banana. Well, they find that very appealing. Oh no. I don't think my banana jokes are working. That's a shame. I have a bunch more for them. You know, let's look at that. We should probably just split. So moving along, over there on the left side of the water, straight ahead, that's our bamboo forest. Now some people say this bamboo can grow all the way up to 6 stories tall. Looks a little more like 7 to me, then that's another story. Guys, check it out. I think I hear at the head, that's an African bull elephant. You can tell because of his large ears, huge tusks, and he's well known for having a great memory. Something I wish I had, right? Oh, hey, up ahead on your right, check it out. That's an African bull elephant. You can tell because of his large ears, huge tusks, and he's well known for having a great memory. Something I wish I had. Excellent timing. I think we're entering into my personal favorite now. It's the great African veldt. And look at all these wild animals that have come out to say hello. We have some of those bearded horses, a few stripy horses, if you zoom in, a few long-necked horses in the back and up. Look at that sleeping stripy horse up there. Oh boy, it looks a little bad. Tired. Oh, we should just let it rest in pieces. Okay, everybody say goodnight, Stripey. Oh no. Wow. I mean, wow. Boy, that was unbelievable. There must have been like a million rocks on that beach. Anyway, we're entering into some serious trouble. This time I'm not joking. Now, Alberta warned me all about these hippos, and they're supposed to be very, very dangerous. So please keep your eyes peeled, all right? Very important, if we see any hippos, you point them out to me, okay? How about if I look out, do you see any hippos? Yeah? Like one or two, maybe? Oh no. Wait a second, actually, there's been a slight change in our plans. It looks like this one up ahead is about to charge. Everybody quick, cover your ears. I'm gonna scare them off real quick and... Wow, that was kind of loud. Alright, I think we're fine though. Don't worry guys, we're gonna be safe and sound from here on out. Oh, that's new. Alright, it looks like we've run into another comedian. Yeah, that's it. He's practicing a few of his jokes for us. Yeah? And what did the monkey say to the banana?
Wait, what?
No, hang on guys, don't go too far. I was trying to keep it clean for the kids. You know what? Never mind guys, next time, okay? Let's just get out of here, it's practice. Okay, there's more. Oh, wait a second. That's actually kind of cute. They found some butterflies. Oh, it's not really something you see every day, but I do. Every single day. But hey, it looks like we made it to the moment you've all been waiting for. It's the one, the only, the eighth wonder of the world. It's the backside of water. O2H. Hey, does anybody like chemistry? You guys do? Hey, that's awesome, right? Everybody, science is fun. All right. Now, lucky for you guys, I had a whole other joke about oxygen and potassium, but it was just okay, so it's okay. I had no idea. There were no warning signs. Uh-oh, it's too hot. We should probably get out of here. Oh, never mind, guys. We're approaching our big finale. Everybody, check it out. It's a gift shop. Oh. Yay! Alright. Everybody make sure you wave goodbye to Ellie down there. She's the one who's looking after our gift shop today, so you gotta give her some extra love. She's doing a great job. So everybody say, bye, Ellie! hang on. She wants to see all of us out here in the jungle. She gets very excited. And Wow. Okay, guys. You should probably wipe some of it off. It might think it's water, but it's not. Anyway, it looks like we're approaching the dock, so you know what that means. Just make sure you're bringing all those hands, arms, elbows, and fingies all the way inside of the boat. You don't want to get anything caught in between the boat and the dock, okay? It causes a lot of peer pressure. I'll try again. Look over there to your right, you'll see a dock. If you look to your left, you'll see another dock. We call it a paradox. It can get a little bit confusing, right, guys? All right, get out.
Delightful way to start our day. Very calm, peaceful beginning. Lovely ride on the Jungle Cruise. Unfortunately, it hasn't helped us, our ride on the Jungle Cruise, in terms of shortening our line, our wait for Tropical Hideaway. That's a longer queue than when we left it. But we're going to get in it anyway because I'm hungry and I have not eaten at Tropical Hideaway. I have not had, you know, proper food. I've had a Dole Whip here, but I haven't ordered a Bao or Olympia or anything like that since pre-COVID. That was the last thing I shot. Oh my gosh. I'm sitting here thinking about this. The last thing I shot, the last video that I did before COVID, before the shutdown, was filming the Bao. I want to say it was like a cheeseburger Bao. And I think I had already had the sweet lumpia at that point. And then they had a peanut butter jelly smoothie type thing, which was gross, over at Maurice's Treats. I did not enjoy that. I think Dylan joined us for that video as well. So that's how long it's been since I've gone through here and ordered some food. I love this place though. Tropical Hideaway is beautiful. They did such a great job on this. Every time I worry about whether or not Disney can pull off, you know, doing things, the last few things that they've done, the bigger projects here, you know, I mean, they haven't done a ride, but you look at Tropical Hideaway, Pelican Landing, those are both really well done, I thought. I mean, but Tropical Hideaway is particularly great. It's really well themed. A vast improvement over the old, Aladdin's Oasis, which was basically just tables. They didn't serve food at all. Occasionally you could meet the genie or Princess Jasmine, but it was just nothing. And this is great. If we're lucky, we're gonna find a table. Looks pretty crowded. If we're double lucky, maybe we'll get something on the rail, though I am not very hopeful of that. Okay, quick wait. It was only about maybe 10 minutes to get my Dole Whip float, which I got. But they're not serving any hot food. No hot food. All I could get is this lousy Dole Whip float. Oh my God. But yeah, I'll give you one guess. Staffing. They don't have enough people here to man the hot food section. They've got enough people for the floats, and that's it. So put in a mobile order for Bengal Barbecue. Gonna wait about 20 minutes for that, then we'll finish our lunch. And I could watch the flow of guests go through Disneyland and do nothing but that. So apparently it's some kind of Tiki Land day. Hi! I've seen so many people in Tiki, like, bounds and tropical shirts and stuff like that. There's even a little treasure hunt that they're doing today. Sounds like fun. I had no idea. How do I not know this? I can tell you the most efficient way to get into Rise of the Resistance, guys, but I could not. I don't know why. I don't ever know when they're doing events. Like, I didn't even know this existed, Tiki Land Day. I would go in there and watch the Tiki Room show, but I wouldn't be able to show you guys any of it because I get copyright blocked on just about the entire show. So we're going to take this show over to Bengal Barbecue to get our lunch.
Ba ba da ba da ba da ba dee ba dee ba da.
which, by the way, see, look. Look, tiki, tiki, tiki. What a cool hat. Look at it, tiki, tiki. Now, it's all I can see now. It's all I can see is just tiki. That's it. I can't see anything else. I feel like I've missed out, but whatever. It's all right. Normally, I'm not much of a tiki art guy, but this right here, it's fantastic. Confessions from a Tropicult is the caption up here. Idol worship. I found Frozen and in Whipped Pineapple Paradise. That is terrific. And then this is a tiki room themed one. Hungry Bill's Two Cannibal Club. You want to have us for dinner? These are great. These are really, really great. They've got a whole setup here for a Tiki Land Day. And I think they're even doing a signing. I think it's Jeff Granito, but I'm not sure. Yeah, this is him, the guy we were just admiring. This is a sticker that's, you know, Jeff Granito on there, and he's signing today. That is great. How much are your stickers, Jeff Granito? Got a cool little kitten one too.
There's the bill case right there. Oh, somebody left their water bottle.
Apparently cats like Dole Whips also. Some tiki heads and tiki bird. Awesome. Oh my god, what is this? Does this exist in our tiki universe? What is it? I don't know why I keep looking at the back. Like it's gonna change. Okay. This reminds me of the Aladdin's Oasis a little bit. That's great. That's some really good stuff. Oh, there's another one. There's the cat again. And a very refreshing looking drink. Here's the fish. It's not. There's a lot of individual so it's not exactly Disney, is it? It's Jeff Granito, because I don't recognize any of these as being strictly Disney type. There's Pac-Man. That's a Pac-Man lime eating Pac-Man ghost. What in the world is going on here? That's so funny. Thought I'd check in on the Indiana Jones collection of artifacts. They have not had any for a while, or they sell out quickly, whatever they had. The voodoo doll's a fairly new addition. Looks like they used to have a Staff of Ra headpiece, but that's gone. That was the one I wanted the most. And I would have been very tempted if I had seen one here. I'm glad that they didn't. I'm glad it's not here, so now I don't have to part with $75 to buy one, because that's like my favorite piece. I'm not sure about the voodoo doll. I'm not sure that I'd want that one. That one doesn't work for me. Unless... Oh, it does come with. It comes with. Okay, that changes things. It's the thing that he pokes it with. The ceremonial, whatever, poker thing. So that makes it a little bit more collectible, doesn't it? All right, let's get that lunch at Bengal Barbecue. Never disappoints. Never in my life have I been disappointed with a meal at Bengal Barbecue. Certainly this will not be any different, I'm sure. There you go, my usual. The Bengal beef skewer and the Outback vegetable skewer. I won't bother reviewing this because I get this literally all the time and have reviewed it 100 times. It's delicious, it's my favorite. And it's even better when you get the extra sauce. Do my eyes deceive me, or does that say 40 minute standby for Indiana Jones and the Temple of the Forbidden Eye? Are we just not going to leave Adventureland today? I'm almost tempted to get in this standby. I'm going to go take a peek. I don't even have to. We're getting in. I can see there's nobody in the back queue. I'm getting in. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. This is like as good as it's gonna ever get for Indiana Jones standby, because the lightning lane merges outside the interior queue. So if you can beat the exterior queue, you've beaten Indiana Jones. Like an idiot, I was in the lightning lane queue. I don't know why I thought that was standby. Look at that. I mean, that's everything right there. 40 minutes. Let's put a clock on it. It is 2:14 when we got. We did this before. What did we do this for? It was like 10 minutes. The wait was 10 minutes. It was said. That's right. Jungle Cruise. We put a clock on it. I forgot to unclock it. Okay, so I just double checked. It was 15 minutes for Jungle Cruise out of a, you know, after a posted 30 minute wait. Posted 40 here. We get in line here at 2:35. I don't know, it's already going kind of slow. I already feel, I think this is a breakdown. Well, I'm positive there was a breakdown, and they've just recently reopened it, but they're gonna give Lightning Lane all the early priority, but there's not, I don't actually see anybody in the Lightning Lane queue right now, so this really, maybe this will get going. But we're already nearly at the ramp. It's been 5 minutes so far, but you can see the effects of the Lightning Lane getting all the priority as they start to, you know, reopen the attraction. This, you know, the standby is starting to fill up and starting to collect guests quickly because it's not moving very quickly. It's not cycling very many guests. So as the people come in, they just kind of park in the queue. So I think we got in at just about the most ideal moment possible for standby after a breakdown, which is, you know, quite fortuitous for our part. Is total victory. That is total victory, man. So now, and that's all, that's what the Lightning Lane guests who are using Lightning Lane for this, that's what they want, is 10 minutes. This is why I'm not a fan of using Lightning Lane for Indiana Jones, unless that queue out there is just packed with folks. Save it for later, or, you know, don't use it at all. Because you can only use one of these things at a time. It's difficult to stack. It's difficult to stack lightning lanes here at Disneyland. Step on the diamond-shaped stone, so we gotta be careful to work around those. We don't want to trigger any spikes.
Council to safeguard your miraculous journey. Here in your transportation devices are ingenious pouches for safekeeping all earthly treasures when the journey becomes bumpy. And to keep you safe and sound, here are special belts attached into the seats. Simply pull it from the right, inserting it into the left, like so. You see the excellence of this invention? Your off-road journey is high-speed and turbulent, going over rough and rugged terrain, and then suddenly you are turning sharply and dropping suddenly. It is unlike anything you have ever experienced, I assure you. Now, my friend, one final word of advice. Once you've entered the chamber of destiny, look not into the eyes of the idol. That would be dangerous. Very dangerous.
Okay.
I love looking through here on my way out, watching vehicles come back. There's one. Badass attractions ever built. It doesn't always run. It breaks down a lot. And it's kind of herky-jerky for a guy like me. But the show is outstanding. It's outstanding show. Bum ba dum bum, bum ba dum. Then you can take 10 minutes walking out of the cube reminiscing about how amazing it was. They really got you back here. A long way from the park proper. Disney Parks needs people like Tony Baxter. Who's leading the imaginary charge right now? The guy really knew how to blend the queue and the show and the ride, the actual thrills and the aesthetic and everything. He knew how to blend it perfectly. One of my favorite things, catching boats on the way out of Indiana Jones. I would have been tempted normally to get on the Jungle Cruise, but we've already been on today. Here they come. Oh, it's training. He's getting his reps in. We got a new skipper on the way, fresh baked. New skipper coming. Look at that. This is surprising. That they didn't fill a queue while we're in there. I would have thought that they would have filled this queue by now. Or most of it anyway. Are people just still not getting in? Is that all that is? There was two little kids in the queue there waving at me. I wasn't sure if they were waving at me at first. And then I realized they were, so I went back. It was lovely. We've been here for about 3 hours. Man, so we just kind of just did Adventureland, didn't we? We went to the Tropical Hideaway. We went to the Jungle Cruise. We got lunch at the Bengal Barbecue. We rode Indiana Jones. I would go to Tiki Room, but I still could, but I can't show you because I'll get a copyright strike on almost all of it, as I mentioned before. I mean, who knows? Maybe we'll go in there. How can I not, right? How can I not go to the Tiki Room on Tiki Land Day? Hey, how's it going? Good, good. Not too busy, huh?
Not too busy.
20 minutes. I just went earlier, so I'm good. I guess I have to, right? It's Tiki Land Day. One in Rome. I wasn't planning on having a Tiki Day, but I've done just about everything you could do on accident almost for Tiki Land Day, except for get a fun festive shirt like that. That's the only thing I haven't done. Do you guys want to take the super secret entrance to get in? Look at that, they're still backed up. We'll take the super secret entrance to get into the Tiki Room. I'm going to show you about 45 seconds of the show, though, if I'm lucky. Dun, 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 dun. I don't want to get in the way of that traffic. I'll take the regular classic entrance. Look like a lot of folks here. Oh, man, what a great hat. What a great hat. I love it. I need to get me that hat.
Linda, wait here, okay? Wait here.
Looks like the timing's pretty good. It's pretty full out here, which means that they're just about ready to open up the show.
To a world of joyous song and wondrous magic, Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room.
Wow, perfect timing. Oh my gosh. We started this video inside the Indiana Jones queue. Right at the exit. Oh my god. And now we're just one shot, one take, all the way into the Tiki Room. That's fantastic, you guys. That's doing Disney right there. You're working, you're watching a pro at work here. Take this back row right here. Change of plans. Better view, better angle in this corner. Hey, the Tiki 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 Room. I love to see this show get filled up. I love to see lots of people in the Tiki Room. I know it's not the best show. It's, you know, it's old school, it's vintage. But it shows respect. It shows, and that's what I love about Disney. There's so much respect and admiration for the nostalgia, the vintage. Walt said this place will never be a museum. And a lot of people refer to that comment when they talk about, you know, expansion and adding more things and growing and things changing. But I disagree. I'm sure he meant it back then. But today, the whole park is sacred to me. I don't want them to change anything, you know? And I love that so many people still pay respect and come and watch the Tiki Room.
Alrighty folks, now she's time to wake up our master of ceremonies, Jose. He loves to take nice long naps in between shows. Hey, Jose, showtime.
Buenos días, this senorita? My siestas are getting shorter and shorter.
I think someone has left the shower running.
They're gonna make you all disappear!
Thank you. Check out the tropical hideaway, guys. Business is a booming. And there's no hot food. This is all Dole Whips. That's wild, man. People love Dole Whips. And there's a whole other cart over there on the other side selling more Dole Whips.
Action, adventure, romance, and a big rock. The Amazon truly does have it all.
They did, though, manage to pay a little homage to the original Aladdin's Oasis. Got a little genie's carpet here. Looks great. I mean, it's a little worse for wear. Some of those tiles have seen better days. I haven't, though. You know, are there any references? I don't recall. Are there references in here to the Tahitian Terrace? I wonder. I know that the sign up there, the Dole Whip, I presume, is a reference to what existed here at the Bengal Barbecue previously. The Bengal Barbecue previously used to be where you could get orange juice. It was called Sunkist, I presume, which is a reference itself to I can't remember in what story or movie or book. Dr. Livingston, I presume. You know what? I'm going to Google that right now. It's not even fiction. That's nonfiction. That's a real person, Dr. Livingston. But it's a thing that somebody had actually said to the Dr. Livingston, who was an explorer, something to that effect. And he arrived at this place and he said, Doctor, I don't know why that would become a famous thing to have said, but apparently it did. Dr. Livingston, I presume. I know growing up, having heard that phrase before and knowing that it was, you know, historical or whatever, I for whatever reason, I had always thought it was a quote from a book. And now I just realized 5 hours later. Is it been five? No, 4 hours later, I'm leaving Adventureland. This is the first time I've left Adventureland since I've been in the park. It is 5 hours. 5 hours later, I spent 5 hours in Adventureland. You guys, seriously, I feel like I don't even know what's going on out here. How's it going out here, Disneyland? How are you guys? That's how it's going. It's going all right. 30-minute wait for Pirates of the Caribbean. I could just walk on right now. Look at that. Is that true? Is that a true story? I don't see any extended queue out here. Okay, hold on. I gotta get in there. I gotta find out what's up. Find a way to wiggle in. Walk right in, right? Are we just gonna walk right into Pirates of the Caribbean right now? Hey guys. I'm gonna take the left side here. I mean, it's not a walk-on, but it's 10 minutes? Okay, here we go. Let's put the clock on. By the way, I forgot to mention, 27 minutes for Indiana Jones. Posted 40, took us 27 to get to our vehicle. We've been in this queue now for just a couple minutes. We got in. It's going to be 10 minutes, if that, on a posted 30. Sundays, man. Sundays are the new Tuesdays. Such an easy trip, man. 10 minutes to our boat. Don't have fancy camp today, so we're gonna have to go with gimbal camp. Does not see well in the dark.
the treasure without a look at this here map.
I haven't seen that top turntable work in a very long time. This one's been dead since pretty much when it reopened back in July.
It's us what needs your running up, not them blasted lovers.
Guys, look, this is the first time I've seen Duke in such a long time. Duke's out there doing work on the Blue Rivers of America. He doesn't work very much. He's been giving a lot of his shifts to other cast members. He just does this job for fun. That's why I love him. Look at that. And then you got this whole scene. Oh my God. Jeez, I just need to stop it. Yeah. You just really need to stop it, Disneyland. You are too great. Oh, man, what a good day. What a good day. A little Adventureland day. I'm happy with this. Quite happy. Guys, okay, let's recap because I was not expecting this. I was expecting it to be kind of busy today because of the way things have been trending. And it probably will be busy tomorrow. After all, Monday's the new Friday. I forget what I said. Saturday. Got here at noon, which is not a good time to get here. I can't remember what time I got here, but it was around that time. Jungle Cruise in 20 minutes. Got a Dole Whip in 10. Indiana Jones in 20 minutes, 25 minutes. Pirates of Caribbean, we even fit in a little Pirates of Caribbean, got that in 10 minutes. We walked into the Tiki Room. We were in the Indiana Jones exit queue. And 7 minutes later, we're watching the Tiki Room in Adventureland. That's outstanding. Had a Dole Whip, got some Bengal barbecue, did a little shopping. That was a heck of a good day. Heck of a good time at Adventureland. I'm very happy with this. Hope you are too. Thanks for watwatching. Follow us on Instagram at @_FreshBaked, on Twitter at @FreshBakedDisney, that's fresh with no E, and on TikTok at @FreshBakedDisney. Gonna slide to the left. If you like our show, want to show your support, please do consider joining our Patreon campaign at patreon.com/freshbake. Otherwise, thanks again for watching, everybody. We love you. Be safe out there. Be kind to one another. Fresh Bake. Bye.